Young at Heart is brought to you by the Dental Implant Institute of Las Vegas and Canyon Gate Medical Group, an OBDS affiliate.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.
The next hour brings entertainment and information for those of you who are young at heart. Here are your hosts, Lynn Peterson and Al Jones.
If you're young at heart.
Welcome to Young at Heart. I'm Lynn Peterson.
And I am Al Jones.
Yes, you are.
And yes.
Y'all are probably wondering why we're sitting outside of Southwest Medical Center. It's just in case, you know, Al gets a little crazy today and, you know, they got a defibrillator back there for him.
Is there a nurse in the house? Is there a nurse in the house?
I think there might be.
You think so?
I think so.
Oh, okay.
And I think that we might even be talking about Southwest Medical
on today's show.
So we'll just have to see what's going to go on. We want you all to remember once again, the new edition of Focus is out in the mail, Focus on TV. And just remember, it's got all the great shows on channel 41 and 46.
That's right.
For the month. So keep it for the month, not a week.
For the whole month.
Isn't that pretty?
Oh, that is so pretty.
So how the heck are you? I heard you up in Reno.
I did. I went to Reno because my cousin, it was her 80th birthday.
Amazing.
They put on a bash there that was just fantastic.
I bet it was.
It was a band, and I didn't realize that my cousin, that she could sing. I didn't know that.
Well, you learn something new every day.
I said, what? We had over 100 people there.
That's fabulous.
Fabulous. Yeah,
well, I'm glad you had a good time this weekend.
I did. I had a good time.
I got to sing.
You did? Did you sing?
Got to sing it was the gathering for the Seroptimists that they got a grant to open up a women's wing in the library here.
Oh, fantastic.
And so we were the entertainment, and we had a great time.
Good.
Great opportunity to hear the Seroptimists talk about what they do in the Valley. And they had some of their national people there, some of the gals from Las Vegas, saying that probably our community of Pahrump and our Seroptimists are recognized throughout the nation for doing some of the most work.
Wow.
For the Valley. I thought that was really great.
That's great.
And do we have anything funny to talk about today?
Well, you do have some little funny, dear. What about this one here, dear?
I got one that says, one out of four. The statistics on sanity is that one out of every four person is suffering from some sort of mental illness. Think of your three best friends, and if it's okay, it's still you.
What are you doing pointing at me for? Shame on you.
No, if they're okay, then it's you. One out of four persons suffering with, I don't know. Anyway.
What about that one?
I don't know. I think this is an actual meeting. I don't think this is a funny. Weight Watchers is going to have a meeting. Let me try that again.
Start over.
Weight Watchers.
Yeah.
They're going to meet at 7 p.m. at First Presbyterian Church. Please use the large double door at the side of the entrance.
Oh, that's cold.
It doesn't say what.
That's cold. She didn't get it.
I thought it was a public announcement.
She didn't get it. She thought it was a public announcement there, you know.
Oh, my goodness. So I guess this other one is not real either. Says the associate minister unveiled the church's new campaign slogan last Sunday. I upped my pledge. Up yours. You know, I bet that was one of those. Have you ever seen where they put it on YouTube or you get sent an email where all the funny sayings on the marquees for different churches or different restaurants? And some of them you wonder, did they really pay attention to what they were putting up there?
They probably did, but they were wondering if the people understood them.
True.
Here's one. I think.
I don't know. It might be a public announcement, probably, no.
It might be. Good morning, team. Dreams and goals are previews of coming attractions in your life. You can be the script writer, the star, and the producer of an
Did you say strip what writer?
I did not. I said script.
Oh, it sounded like you said strip writer.
No. Okay. Of an act. Oh, you made me forget where I was.
That's easy.
Or an extra in a B-movie that someone else wrote and directed for you. Which will it be?
I don't know. Did we even understand what he said? But, I mean, there were too many things we were talking in between.
I'll do it next time.
We'll do it next time because we don't. Yes, we have so much time. We can do it next time. Dreams and goals are previews of coming attractions in your life. You can be the scriptwriter, the star, and the producer of an Oscar-winning epic life, or an extra B. Oh, an extra in a B. An extra in a B movie.
Uh-huh.
I'm dyslexic. Give me a break.
Okay.
Or you can be an extra in a B movie that someone else wrote and directed for you, which is it to be. This is serious. It's saying exactly.
It is serious.
This makes sense to me.
She gave us serious stuff.
Absolutely. Well, let's get serious. We've got some great guests on the show. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the show, folks. My next guest is, and that's from my, let's see, this is my right, isn't it?
Correct.
Am I right? Is Marsha Anderson, and in the center here is Mr. Dennis Martin. And they are here from Southwest Medical.
Associates.
Mm-hmm. Southwest Associates.
Southwest Medical Associates.
Associates. Well, that's, mm-hmm. I just left off the associates. Tell me what that is now, and let's talk to the people about what Southwest Medical is all about.
Okay. Well, Southwest Medical Associates has actually been in the Valley for approximately 30 years, mm-hmm. in the greater Las Vegas Valley, and we've actually been in Pahrump for 26 years.
I didn't know that.
Not Southwest Medical Associates, but our parent company, mm-hmm. Health Plan of Nevada.
Oh, okay.
And so, but as far as Southwest Medical Associates go, we're a very large, in fact, the largest multi-specialty group, mm-hmm. in Nevada, and we provide all types of care from birth to seniors. We have a number of sites in Las Vegas and one here in Pahrump. We're talking about that today.
Yeah, well, I understand that you're building a new clinic here.
Yeah, we're building a new clinic on Calvada Boulevard, mm-hmm. at 2210 East Calvada Boulevard. It's under construction as we speak, mm-hmm. and we're looking forward to a early summer opening.
Summer opening. Mm-hmm. Ah, now what kinds of things will be happening in there? What kind of, I should say, what kinds of things will you be doing in there?
Let me give you, and then Dennis can please chime in at any time. First of all, you know, with Health Plan of Nevada and Senior Dimensions and some of our Sierra and Health and Life products, we have over 6,100 insured patients here in Pahrump, in the Pahrump Valley. And of those, 3,700 are Senior Dimensions. And so I believe it was June of 2010, Southwest Medical Associates purchased Dr. Levisor's practice on Commercial Drive,
2270 Commercial Drive.
2270 Commercial Drive. And we have already outgrown that space.
Wow.
We are adding a new provider, Dr. James Wang, and he'll be starting. He's actually started. He's getting oriented in one of our other clinics, and we'll be joining Dr. Levisor probably in the next couple months.
We're hoping to get him out here to work a few days a week, mm-hmm. probably end of March, early April.
Mm-hmm. But one of the things that, you know, Southwest Medical Associates realized early on was that Pahrump has experienced exponential growth.
That's right.
And in fact, all of the Las Vegas Valley and Nye County have, but the healthcare has not kept pace with that. And we are, you know, we at Southwest Medical Associates would like to expand those services more in Pahrump because we have so many patients here. And for the most part, the folks have to come over into Las Vegas for a number of services. So with building this new clinic, we're hoping that we can provide a number of those services here locally so that we can save and it be more convenient care for our patients. Certainly we're going to provide primary care because that's important for all aspects, and then we have some other things that we're going to be bringing in from Las Vegas on a routine basis here to our new clinic site. Currently we have podiatry, who's coming in every other Friday and seeing our patients here at Dr. Levisor's office. And then Dennis, you want to talk about some of the other things that will be in the new clinic?
Yeah.
We're looking forward to rotating additional specialists through the new clinic as well, on top of the podiatry services that have already started, possibly endocrinology, cardiology, some pediatric providers coming through the new clinic. The new clinic is going to be much larger than the existing one. We're going to have 12 exam rooms, general radiology that will give us the capability to do chest x-rays, abdominal x-rays, extremity x-rays, which will provide the the doctors with that more immediate diagnostic capability on site. And along with that is going to expand what we can do. We're really looking forward to identifying what the community needs and then bringing those resources into Pahrump. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be an evolution of the clinic, you know, from where it starts to where it ends.
Well, you know, these are things that I think that the people out here, especially the seniors out here, and me, a senior, need. Mm-hmm. And I'm with the Senior Dimensions. Mm-hmm. So these are services that that we need, and I don't have to go over over the hill there. Mm-hmm. Now, this is considered as being a clinic that will service the people here in Pahrump, basically with the different things that you're talking about. Mm-hmm.
Correct. Now, if you're a Southwest Medical Associates member, you would get all of your services at our new site, like you are currently getting with Dr. Levasseur. However, we have a number of providers contracted in Pahrump who provide care to members for Health Plan of Nevada and Senior mm-hmm. Dimensions, who also then can see our specialists at this new location. Mm-hmm. So it would be, we hope, very convenient and meet the needs of the folks here at Pahrump.
One of the other things that we're hoping to open up with at the new clinic is our sister company, THC, mm-hmm. is also expanding into Pahrump, and we're looking at giving them some space in the new clinic to provide durable medical equipment that individuals with mm-hmm. senior dimensions or Health Plan of Nevada may have to go to Las Vegas for. So mm-hmm. on top of providing additional medical resources, we're also bringing durable medical equipment out to Pahrump. Mm-hmm.
Now, I understand also that some of the doctors are going to possibly have communication with some of the seniors showing them kinds of things that they never knew about before.
Right. We have, we're very blessed to have some fabulous specialists at Southwest Medical Associates. And what we've begun doing is lecture series or talks with some of our, all of our specialists. Most recently, we had Dr. Sklaparis, who's our chief of cardiology, give a talk. And at the end, it was well attended by over probably 100 or so attendees. And what they said is, you know, no one ever told me what hypertension is. And so finally, Dr. Sklaparis drew the heart on the board and explained how it works and why this occurs. And, you know, all you know when you go to the doctor is you have high blood pressure. But he actually brought it to a level where everyone could understand it. So we're hoping to bring our specialists out, you know, and have these types of forums, invite all of the folks in the the KBVM community to come out and listen and learn, and, you know, in an attempt to stay healthy and well.
You know, I think that this is a very good idea, because a lot of things over the years I've never understood. Mm-hmm. You go to the doctor said, well, I see that you have this is up a little high here. Okay, I'll tell you what you do. Take this pill here, and then it'll go down here, okay? Mm-hmm. But I wanted to know exactly, in layman's terms,
right?
You know, what's going on here with me? Why am I like this? Why am I like that? Well, actually, I don't know, Al, but take this pill here and come back tomorrow and see me. Mm-hmm. So what you're saying, you're going to have some of the specialists come out and talk to the people.
Right. And, you know, we have endocrinology who deal with diabetes and other issues that are pretty prevalent here. We have a specialist in women's health who can talk about taking care of yourself. It's not just young women, it's older women who need to continue to take care of themselves. And so we'll have a number of different specialists who can come out and provide that type of forum for mm-hmm. the folks in Pahrump.
One of the other services that we currently started providing at the clinic for Health Plan and Senior Dimensions patients was the Health Education and Wellness mm-hmm. Division of the Health Plan has started seeing patients out here the first Friday of every month.
Wow.
And they're sending a nutritionist out, and she speaks with about 5 patients the first Friday of every month. And once they identify other needs in the community, they'll send out additional educators. And in the new building, we'll have much more space for those patients to come.
I really like that idea when you talk about nutrition, mm-hmm. because a lot of us do not eat like we're supposed to. I mean, it's been a while, at least I always try to do, but letting the people know exactly, hey, vegetables, more vegetables, mm-hmm. Make sure that you don't do this and do that. I need that information.
And
myself.
The guidelines have changed.
Yes.
Definitely. The guidelines have changed. And, you know, so it's important to know, you know, because we have such hypertension and diabetes mm-hmm. and obesity mm-hmm. in our communities, and this is really important to No one can do it. You can do it with the help of a physician, but you need to have the education to help yourself.
Now, when you talk about stress, I was just wondering, are they going to talk about the what happens or why stress, you know, is prevalent in each individual, or they can come in? I know each one of them is different, but talk about stress and say, well, what's causing you to be stressed, and what are some of the remedies for that?
I know we could certainly provide an forum for that. And I think the more we hear, as folks come to attend these and they say, well, we'd like to hear about this, that, or the other topic, we certainly can provide that. We have a great depth and breadth of providers and resources to help us with that.
As I said earlier, we're really looking for the clinic to evolve over time. We want to identify the needs of the community. So if it's speakers, you know, from our behavioral health to come out, we would be happy to set that up. Doing sports physical clinics in the beginning of the summer, or at the end of the summer for school. Whatever the clinic identifies that they need.
That's it.
I know we had the flu clinics here that were very, very well received,
good.
And the pneumonia, and so we're definitely going to do that again next year.
Okay. Give us a telephone number if they want to call for more information.
I would say that you can call 702-877-5199, and that's our Southwest Medical Associates main direct number.
Okay, we're going to put that up on the air, you know. So I want to thank you, too, for coming and
thank
sharing
you for
this information.
Us.
Thank
and look,
you, Al.
I'm looking forward for seeing you guys.
Southwest Medical. We're happy to be here, and
very
thank
good.
You for having us. We really enjoy the opportunity. Thanks
you
so
are
much.
Most certainly welcome. Stay tuned, folks. We shall return after these messages. Don't go away.
Welcome back to the show. My next guest, we have the Action Club. And this is a club that is for adults with disabilities.
Yes.
And we have Amber, who is an active member, along with Jeff. And
Nick.
Then we also
Nick,
have
Nick.
This is Nick.
You know who I was thinking? You know, it's so funny because we talked about this with Nick. My son's name is Nick. You think
you
I remember his
it.
Name? And I said to you, I will never forget your name. And what do? I called you Jeff. Jeff's our camera guy.
And we're on the
I am the president of Action Club.
Yes, Amber is the president of Action Club. And you,
I'm
Stephanie,
the advisor.
You are the advisor for the kids. But it's basically you all that take over what the Action Club does, right?
Mm-hmm.
Can you explain a little, Jeff? Jeff, Nick?
Nick.
Poor Nick.
I'm okay. Going to start calling my son Jeff now, you know?
Just call me Jeff. You've been
okay,
calling
Jeff.
That.
Jeff. Nick, seriously. Can you tell us a little bit about what the Action Club is, what it actually does?
What do we do?
We sponsor, like,
All sorts of events
and stuff and stuff.
What did we do last with the preschool class?
We gave the preschool class a sandbox.
Which preschool was? Is it just the one here in Pahrump?
How many preschools
here in Pahrump?
It's not. It was a preschool class over by the high school.
Okay.
And I don't know. I think there's only the two.
Okay. And so you all raised the money to be able to. Give them a sandbox. I think that's great.
It was awesome. They had lots of fun.
I'm gonna donate some tapes to them too.
What did you do, Amber, honey?
I'm gonna donate Barney tapes to them.
Are you? That's fabulous. Now, Amber, you've been involved with the Action Club for quite a few years, right?
When we first started, we were at the Beehive when I was 18 years old when we first started.
That's great. And you've really enjoyed doing your work there, right? And what is the most
all
fun
I get
part?
To do is ring the bell.
You ring the bell. What? That's important. That starts the meetings, right?
Yes.
How often do you meet?
Every Tuesday.
We meet every Tuesday at 3 o'clock.
Okay. Now, Jeff.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
You know what I like about Nick? He's such a good sport. Just put it down to age, okay?
Yeah.
My memory's going.
They know because I go through all the guys' names in the club first before I get to their names.
We have Justin, Bobby, Tammy. And Aaron.
Okay.
And now Billy.
All right. Billy?
Yeah.
So tell us, Billy. Nick. I'm just teasing you.
Oh, boy, this is a good copy to send to
you. Okay.
Yes, it is a very good copy.
Get serious, please. Be serious. No, I'm just kidding. How long have you been with the club? Don't remember. It's been so long.
Almost a year.
Almost a year.
Oh, really? Okay, so you're kind of new at it, but what is your favorite thing about doing the club? What do you like to...
Hanging out with friends.
Hanging out with friends.
Yes.
And it is a good environment to have your friends there that you can talk about things that you have in common, too. Mm. And I'm sure it's a safe environment for
it's a very safe environment.
Yeah, because the club was started for adults with disabilities primarily, but they do so much good in the
community. Of people figure that they can't do anything, that they don't have the abilities to go out and take care of something for someone,
right?
And we do a lot of service projects, and we go to fundraisers and food drives and all kinds of things to help the children, because Kiwanis's theme is young children priority one,
right?
So the Action Club just plays on that also and carries that on also.
And this is a Kiwanis sponsored
yes it's
club.
A Kiwanis International, and this is an SLP, which is a sponsored leadership program through Kiwanis.
And Nick, what's the latest fundraiser that you have right now that you all are doing? Something about gas cards?
Yeah, what it is we sell gas cards.
We're having a raffle.
We're having a raffle.
For a $500
gas card. $500 gas card.
That's pretty cool. I mean, right now, especially with gas going up to almost $4 a gallon, getting that card for $500 is pretty wise. And you're selling these...
We're selling them...
Everywhere?
To raise money to go towards our trip to California.
Now, what are you going to do in California for your trip? Is it something special, like going to a national organization, or is it just
our convention? It's our convention, but we have fun there. What did you do last year? Do you remember?
It was so long ago, and you're getting old.
No. We did
fishing. Did you get a little medal for fishing?
Yes.
You got a medal for fishing?
Yes, and I'm not a fisher.
Where do you fish in California?
It's at Wonder Valley Ranch. It's over just below Fresno, California.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Did you have a good time? So every year you have these conventions throughout. Are they always in this area of California?
They have been. They've only been for 3 years. The Action Club is brand new. It's only like 3 years old. I think it's really three years old.
Okay.
So there's already about 400 clubs now worldwide.
Wow. And so to raise this money for the Action Club to take their trip to California, is this for all the members?
Yeah, there's 10 of us that are going to be going.
There's 10 members, okay.
There's eight members, but we have our advisors who are going also.
Okay.
So, that's going to help us all with the gas, with the registration fee and the rental of the car.
Now, these tickets can be bought. I know that there are several locations, and they're usually members, Kiwanis members that have...
Kiwanis members. Yeah. Some of them have them, but we're going to have three separate events coming up before the actual raffle is on the 12th of June. The first one's going to be our yard sale on 26th of March on Basin. It's where Kiwanis usually has their yard sale, in Ken Murphy's Plaza. Then we're going to have... we're going to be at the Valley Auto, the Cruiser Show, the Valley Cruisers car show in the park on the 16th of April. And then on the 12th of June, we're going to have a car wash in front of Woofie's.
Wow. And then the raffle actually takes place.
It's the 12th.
12th of June.
Yes.
Okay. So you got a couple of months to buy these tickets, then it's well worth it. These kids so deserve to have some fun after all the great stuff they do in the community. You wanted to say something, Amber?
When we were at Econ Forum, we got to make a quilt for a lot of kids. I got to take our pictures and they sewed it into quilts.
Yeah, that was fun.
That sounds like that would have been up your alley. You're very an artistic girl, and that sounds like you had a great time doing that.
Honestly, well, my sister does too.
Yes, definitely.
She's 22.
Now, Nick, you had fun with this club. Do you see continuing on with it throughout the years?
And yes.
Don't you? You wanted to tell people out there that you'd love to have more members coming and join the club. Would you like to have more members coming? What are the requirements?
The requirement is only that you are 18 years old and that you have a disability. We meet at the school, Palm Valley High School. Tuesdays at 3 p.m. to 5 p.m.
Is that every Tuesday?
Every Tuesday. Building B, room 31. And we're on the school's calendar, so we stop for the summertime. But we do summer events. We go swimming every day at the pool, and we do stuff. So.
And is there a cutoff age? You start at 18.
You just have to be 18, no.
Okay,
no
so
cutoff.
It's for all adults.
Yes.
Okay, that sounds like so much fun. And I know that you all have been very intricate in events like the PV pack and the...
We try to help whoever and whatever we can do. We did an annual play day, but because the community center is closed, we canceled that event this year. We're sorry that we had to do that. But we had stations for the children, the young children, to play it and have lots of fun, and we gave lots of gifts. So we really are really kind of geared toward the children.
Right, which has always been a Kiwanis thing anyway.
Major.
Now, you have a phone number where people can contact you if they need to get a hold of either information about Action Club and also for the raffle tickets.
Exactly. My phone number is 513-0466. We also have a website. It's actionclubofpurump.org. Also, KPV, which is the Kiwanis Club of Pahrump Valley. You can find a link there on that to ours.
And hopefully we can have Jeff put all that information up. And Action is actually spelled A-C.
A-K.
Oh, I'm sorry, A-K. Okay, that means the real Action spell.
Yes, it's A-K-T-I-O-N.
Just like on Nick's shirt.
Yes.
Oh my goodness gracious, I am so dyslexic. It's unbelievable. So... Is Amber, do you have any other things that you would like to tell people out there about the club and why it's so important to you? Why they, everybody should come on down and be a part of it?
Well, I wrote a song for the club a long time ago when I was 19.
Yes.
A very good song. She played piano and wrote the song.
Yes, we are Action Club.
It's a very good one. It's on the website.
That's great.
It's going to be on the website.
Thank you very much for saying that for us. I mean, she just did that. You're not shy,
no.
Are you? No. It's only Nick, pseudo Jeff, that we have to be concerned about.
And Billy, you know.
And Billy and Aaron and all that stuff. Oh, my goodness gracious. Again, give us a telephone number.
513-0466. I'm Stephanie Bosick, and I'm the advisor.
Yes, that way you can get any more information, and honest to goodness, they would love all, anybody that has it in their heart to be a part of the community and to do worthwhile and to show the community that adults with some disabilities can make a difference in our community. I thank you all for coming in so much.
Thank you, Lynn.
10 minutes went?
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the show, folks. Hey, listen, as far as those who need dental implant, now Rhonda Van Winkle, she had an interview with the doctor here from dental implant. So why don't we just watch?
Dr. Cha, it's so nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
Thank you. So last time we were together, we had just started talking about seniors and how many of them have dentures that may not fit well, or they're in pain, they have a hard time eating corn on the cob, things like that. Can you expand on that more for our audience?
It's a very, very common problem, and it's actually a very, very sad to see. And a lot of these seniors, and it's actually my mother-in-law is a perfect example. And she had a car accident when she was in her 50s. And on top of the car accident, she had a jaw tumor, where she was kind of forced to lose majority of her lower teeth due to the tumor retrieval. And not only the majority of the teeth, but she was forced to lose majority of her jawbone at the same time. So she was forced to wear dentures for most of her later part of her life, and now she doesn't even have any bone to wear her dentures. So my husband put on some implants for her in whatever the remaining of the jawbone that she had, but it still was not enough number of implants to stabilize her dentures. So it's still, even though she has some implants, still it's not enough implants. So she's still having a hard time. But if a lot of the people who wear dentures now, if they can put on some implants now that actually preserves jawbone to be able to wear their dentures for the longer period of their lifetime.
So why does it help preserve the bone?
Because the jawbone, they need stimulation in order to keep their jawbone. If they don't have any teeth, their jawbone feels like they don't need to be there anymore. So the jawbone shrinks and shrinks and shrinks. There's actually two layers of jawbone. They have a mandible that is part of the skull, and they have an alveolar bone that is holding on to the roots of your teeth. So as soon as the teeth are gone, their alveolar bone continues to shrink every year because there's no more stimulation. So each teeth have ligaments. The roots stimulate the alveolar bone to continue to stay there. So once the teeth are gone, their stimulation are gone, so the alveolar just disappears every year. But if the implants are in place right away or soon, their implant chewing action, the implant will stimulate the alveolar bone and continue to stay there. So sooner you can place implants, their alveolar bone will stay, so your jawbone will stay. So your structure of your face will stay there.
So we can actually say that it would be healthier to have implants than not to.
Exactly. And you will look younger because your more of your jawbone will stay there to make you look like you have a more of a structure. Your facial structure will remain there.
And probably a lot of people don't realize that they're going to start losing their bone if they just have dentures.
Exactly.
So let's say we have a patient who has lower dentures completely.
Right.
And it hasn't been too long. They can come to you. And what if they can only afford just a few implants?
Well, the minimum number of implants that you need to have is 2 in this canine region or eye teeth region. Then let's say that will actually help you maintain the front part of your region, but you can always add more later on. And their dentures are usually held on by buttons. And then if you decide to have 2 more later on, you can add 2 more buttons, which will be stronger later on.
Okay, so you can do this in phases if you need to.
Yeah, you can add on or upgrade.
I see. And now if you need upper and lower, can you also do that in phases?
Yes, you can do 2 in the front and then you can add on and 2 in the back.
Very good. Yeah. Now, there are patients that have dentures that are not fitting well and therefore they're having a hard time eating. Have you had patients come in who are in essence starving themselves because they can't eat?
Well, they're getting malnourished or they're getting stomach problems. Their GI, they're constantly getting GI upsets or they're getting a problem digesting their food properly. So they're actually getting problems internally or organ-wise. So it's medically necessity to have implants or improve their nutrition in order to do that. But unfortunately, anything that's in their mouth, the medical insurance do not want to deal with it. Because, mm-hmm. you know, insurance companies here for business reasons, not to really help people, it's kind of sad, but all the largest, tallest building in each city are owned by the insurance companies.
So some insurance companies might cover dentures, but they're not necessarily covering implants.
Oh, for sure. But the medical insurance do not want to cover implants either because they know it's an expensive item.
I see. Well, you know, in time, implants are becoming more and more popular. People are starting to learn about them, and eventually it might be the only way to go. We never know. With your help and doctors like you.
It's the future of dentistry.
It is.
It is. It's going to bypass root canals. It's going to bypass dentures, definitely bypass any kind of bridges or crowns.
Well, it's like going on a computer instead of an old-fashioned typewriter.
Oh, exactly.
It's time to progress. It
yes.
is. So what's the favorite part of your job and what you do for people?
My favorite part of job, satisfied patients, which is ultimately what we want. I mean, we are here to please people. I guess psychologically, we're people pleasers. We want everybody to be happy.
Do you have a story you want to share with us of a patient in particular that it was a really good experience?
Well, everything is a good experience, but it just there's so many, it's really hard to pinpoint.
I'm assuming that they feel so much more confident about themselves, and some of them probably just they aren't getting sick anymore.
I cannot think of offhand, but there's many stories.
It's kind of like you said last time we met. You were talking about architecture, mm-hmm. and how you actually get to work on your building is their mouth.
Yeah, well, I like to see something out of nothing. People with really bombed out mouth, with beautiful mouth. Mm-hmm. I like to see from nothing to something beautiful. I think that's how a lot of the contractors or architects like to see mm-hmm. from nothing, from flat ground zero to something beautiful.
And they love it too. I'm sure it does so much for their self-confidence. Just like, you know, when you're younger, braces do so much for you. When you're older, especially if they have the receding gums and they're really in bad shape, you're working on that. Plus, they might be getting implants, correct?
Yes. What I like to see is somebody who never put makeup on their face, and all of a sudden they got beautiful teeth, and they come back with makeup and total makeover of their hair and beautiful clothes, and it's like, wow, I never thought that you had that kind of potential just because they fixed their teeth.
Yes, yeah. You have an impact on people's lives.
Yeah, sometimes I never think about it, but I do.
You do, yeah. It's pretty exciting. So we talked a little bit about it last time, and I know that you fell in love with biology at a young age when you were going to college, and you went into this field. What particularly attracted you to cosmetic surgery? I mean, dentistry, excuse me.
Dentistry. It was a natural progression. When we fixed their teeth to be chewable state in the back area, it was a natural progression where people ask to fix their front teeth for cosmetic purposes. Remember, I'm a periodontist by trade, which means I fix their chewing ability or their back teeth. I'm a foundation person. So it was a natural thing for us to give them back teeth, their implants in the back teeth to chew. And it was never a cosmetic purposes in the front. It was patients' request to fix their front teeth. So actually I had to go back to teaching institution or these seminars to learn veneers in the front, because cosmetic is not my nature. I'm a periodontist, so I had to go back and learn those cosmetic seminars to learn those things. So actually I went back to school to learn those things that patient wanted me to do for them to fulfill their needs.
Very good. Well, we're learning more and more about you, and I really appreciate your time, and I know that our audience in Pahrump is really going to just love you. They're going to want you to take care of all their issues all at once. So we're going to see you again next month, and we'll talk to you more. We'll go into it a little further, and I just want to say thank you again for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Now, that was a very interesting interview with the Dental Implant Institute of Las Vegas. We'll be back. Stay tuned.
Welcome back here to the Wild Wild West. I am with the Waterstones, a shooting up and rocking group, and we've got Granny, who we love. Come up here, Granny, with me.
Wait, okay? Yeah, sure. Yeah, oh, geez, you're just a tiny little thing, ain't you, girl?
Well, I'm wearing my tall boots today.
Oh, yeah.
And we have Slim, who is our notorious bad guy in the background, of course, Sheriff
Joe, Hawkeye Joe.
Hawkeye Joe.
He's my man, you know.
It's another J. I may be calling him Hawkeye Jeff. You never know. Anyway, we are with the Waterstones now. I need to ask you a good question. How did you come up with the name Waterstones?
That's interesting. We're actually the Waterstone Bunch.
Okay.
Well, Pahrump means water from the stone.
Absolutely.
So we didn't want to call ourselves the Pahrump Bunch, so we're the Waterstone Bunch.
But the Pahrump Bunch has a really great ring to it.
Oh,
if you
no.
think about it, you know, it kind of depicts the Wild Wild West.
No, we're the Waterstone Bunch. That sounds even better. Because,
yes.
You know,
closer
Pahrump's
to the Wild
got
West.
A lot of stones out there.
I'm not going to comment on that. We'll just let that one go over my head. No, just kidding. Now, you all have been around in the Valley for a long time, although, Slim, you're new to our show, are you not?
No, I'm not new. I'm just normally working somewhere else.
Mm-hmm. Oh, is that what? Oh, so you're like a gun for hire? You kind of like go wherever your gun takes you?
You said it. I didn't. There's probably a lawman out there watching this right now.
Yeah, he's right next to you.
Uh-huh.
Did you not hear the part where I said sheriff?
Yeah, well.
Sheriff, I might remember or forget the rest of the name, but I remember the sheriff part. Now, do you have any events coming up in the spring, summer that you can tell us about?
We do. We've got an RGA Grand National event. It's a competition for gunfighters.
Come up here.
And gunfighter groups. It's going to be in Jean, Nevada at the Gold Strike.
Okay.
It's sponsored by the RGA, which is the Reenactment Guild of America. The Gold Strike Hotel Casino in Jean is putting it on for us, and there's a lot of prize money involved. There's going to be 10 to 12 gunfighter groups there. There's going to be encampment set up for
mm-hmm.
people to see that their period.
And everything is authentic to that
period.
Authentic to the period.
Yeah, I remember last time you were here, we were talking about that you can get disqualified if there's anything that is not specific to that period. Now, you can't, I mean...
You can have reproductions, remember,
right,
also.
Right, reproductions, but they cannot be...
And reproductions for the period.
Because you were talking, like, your glasses.
Yes, I specifically went round glasses because it's the closest I could come to period. Mm-hmm. I've been looking, trying to find a pair of actually authentic glasses, but they're hard to come by.
I bet.
And so I just told the judges. And hard to see out of. Yeah, well, mine are prescription also.
Okay.
So it's hard to see. And yeah. I took them off once. I tried it once without them. But
did they give you a gun after that?
Hell no.
Probably afraid you'd hit Slim in a place that hurt, and then he'd come gunning for you.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no. You don't hurt the ladies there.
Did you hear that, Slim?
Yeah, I heard. Yeah,
they're kind of far and few between.
You got to watch Slim, though. He'll hurt anybody.
Yes.
He don't care.
Now, in these competitions, Sheriff, there's also shooting competitions, or is it mostly reenactments?
Reenactments.
And the costume and the authenticity.
There is shooting in the skits.
Right.
It's with blanks.
But it's not like you're going to be shooting tin cans to see who shoots the most tin cans.
No.
Did they have tin cans back in the 1800s?
Sure. Yeah. The sheriffs made their badges out of them.
Oh, that's where they came
that's
from.
That's where they came
from.
Oh,
God, I thought it came from the tin
sheriff
quarry.
Badges were made out of
peaches. Right down by the riverbank, you know? You know, I got to admit, Slim is probably the only stereotypical gunslinger. Slinger. God. Somebody just shoot me, don't. That actually talks a lot. I mean, you're depicted in movies and things like that as very quiet, kind of solemn guy.
Well, normally I am quiet, but folks need to know where we're going to be.
That's very important. Now, the prizes and everything, this is just for your entertainment and the entertainment of the community, correct? Or is there, do you do charity work? And
oh, we've done ribbon cutting ceremonies. We've went up to grand openings. We're going to be in the Relay for Life.
That's fabulous.
Yes. We're not going to be relaying, but we're going to be there performing.
That's
good.
We were
just in the Spring Fling Cowboy thing.
That's right, for their benefit.
Yes, we did a Western fashion show.
Uh-huh. How did that go?
Oh, it was wonderful. They just love Slim. You should have seen him. I ain't never seen so much hardware on anybody in my whole life.
You in a fashion show?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'm impressed.
Don't you like this manly physique?
Thank you. That's pretty hot there, Masa.
It's on account of this physique here. They call me Slim.
I got that. And I like right the handsome. Tassel and everything. You got it all going there.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah. You know, he's kind of cute.
Ain't he cute?
For a bad guy.
Now, so Joe's my good handsome, too, ain't he? Look at him. Oh, he's good looking. He's tall.
You like tall. You like him
tall.
You like him
tall. He's way up there.
He was way up there, and you're like, you don't even have, do you have boots with heels on today?
No, but Granny don't wear boots, honey. I'm a frontier woman. I'm the backbone of the old West, you know.
Okay, then tell us a little, what exactly is the backbone of the old West? What would you depict grannies back then as?
Remember, we went out there, and we married men, we raised children and family. Do you know 63% of the women died in childbirth before the age of 40 and looked 60? Oh, yeah, very hard life. Remember, your washtub and your washboard. Oh, geez, skin your knuckles doing that, too, you know.
Hard to believe she's only 30 years old.
Yes, it is. And I noticed the little diamond nose ring, and I'm like thinking, they had us back in the 1800s.
That's not allowed in competition. You remove that.
I have to take that out in competition.
But you know what? That's what 30-year-old women do. You know, they got to have that little spunky thing. Actually, you probably went out and got a little nail stud because you're a tough woman of the Wild Wild West, and you just stuck it right there in your nose.
Oh, well, let's face it. Beyond every great man, there's a woman pushing.
I heard that.
Yeah. And we kept the families together. And got to remember, women's suffrage, got rid of the alcohol, brought churches and schools into the old Western towns and everything so we could educate our children. Why, what would a woman do?
That's what turned Slim into a bad man.
I was going to say, keep your guns holstered.
Took away my alcohol.
And don't forget about them women the night, that them soiled doves. We run them out of town, too.
You should run for governor. I mean, isn't there something like that in
she
the
She may
balance?
As well just paint a big target on her forehead. She does that.
Uh-oh. I can see a new skit coming up, can't you?
Can't make everybody happy, you know.
Yes. So, yeah. Sheriff, how long have you been Sheriff of Water World?
Water World? Well,
I feel like I'm the in this alternate stone world. Bunch. Oh, I have a gun in my back. I hope it's a gun in my back.
He might be happy to see you, honey. Make watch out.
Are the kids gone? When do we show this show? What time of the day? This portion is going to be edited. Oh, look at how red he got.
Is that one of my guns?
I told you he was happy to see you.
Riding on the range. Just riding on the range. So how long have you been sheriff?
I've been Fort Drayton sheriff for about 5 years now.
Okay. And you must absolutely just love it.
Oh, yeah.
He looks the part of an old town sheriff.
You are so in love with this man. I can just tell.
We've been going together now 5 years.
Well, you better get married, you know.
Huh?
You said women of the Wild Wild
West. Well, women, we didn't want to spoil a good thing.
But you said you were a tough woman. You could handle marriage.
She's already handled 8 of them.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
You are
and
tough.
I can't has children no more, you know. I've been fixed. I can't has puppies.
She's been spayed.
That old bag of wind shouldn't be better than no more children anyway.
It's local TV. What can I say? It is prump. It's still the Wild Wild West out here. I used to always say that all the time. First time I lived here. Now look at me now. I'm back.
Isn't it wonderful?
I love Pahrump. It's such a beautiful community.
It is.
And now we've got the hospital, and Southwest is coming out, and Senior Dimensions is good for us and everything. So
hire her. She's good for us.
I'm telling you.
Oh, really? Really? Could you see a commercial with them, you know, for Southwest Health, or Associates?
Medical Associates.
Okay, so Medical Associates.
She needs a little breakthrough.
I've lost it today, but you know what? You guys would make a great commercial. You really would. Now, we're running out of time. Unfortunately, 10 minutes flies. Where's your next event? Relay for Life or something before that?
Well, on May 14th and 15th, it's down in Jean at the Gold Strike for the national competition.
That's the competition. And everybody, it's open to the public, so you can get information. What's the number?
You can call me if you dare.
He's looking for me.
It's 513-8781.
8781, 513-8781. Thank you all for coming out. We love you. You'll be back. I'm going to go recover now. Talk to you later. See y'all later.
Welcome back.
Did we have fun on this show or what?
Oh, did we have? I tell you, it was fantastic. I enjoyed
it. It was lots of fun. We have to welcome Southwest Medical Associates to Pahrump.
That's right.
They've got a great facility going on, and I'm sure
it'll be great.
And we're going to probably have some of those guest speakers on, or the specialists, so that we can give you some of the information that they'll be doing at some of these seminars too. So it'll be great.
It'll be fantastic.
Yes, it will.
Some things I don't know yet, even though I've been around a little while.
Absolutely. And you know what? The Waterstone Bunch, I think it would be fantastic. Go and see them perform in Jean. And that's, in May 14th and 15th.
Yeah.
And that's Jean, Nevada.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yeah. That's, okay. It wouldn't be in Arizona. I mean, come on.
Well, it could be California.
No.
I'm trying to. Oh, okay. It's before Prim. Yeah. But that should be a lot of fun.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Without a doubt.
Yep. And we thank the Action Club for being here and the lovely Amber singing her theme song.
Oh, yes. That was great.
We've got some great guests coming up next week.
Yes. The sheriff is going to talk about drinking and driving.
Yes.
That's
and
one thing.
The bad things about it.
Right.
Obviously.
That's true.
And who else do we have?
Town manager's going to come on.
Yeah. Should be interesting to see where our town is heading in the next year or so.
Right.
Be nice to see what plans Pahrump has for all of the changes coming up, I hope. Good things are coming.
It is. Cooking, and I'm going to be cooking.
We're going to be cooking. That's right.
Yeah, cooking.
What are we cooking?
The food.
No, we're going to be eating the food. They're going to be cooking the food. Is it Kendrick? I think it's Chef Kendrick.
Kendrick's probably will cook something from the steakhouse.
Really good.
We enjoyed that last time. In fact, we didn't leave any. It was.
When do we go back? I want to go back.
Want to go back?
Yes.
Okay, we'll go back.
Yeah.
Do that again.
We got to do that again. And there's a little. Oh, you had something. You went.
No,
and?
I didn't. No.
Oh.
I want you to.
Yeah,
that's it.
A run-on sentence.
Yes, run on.
Oh. Pat, our lovely producer, gave us. This little tidbit, good thoughts of the day. If you're going to kill time, it will be best to work it to death.
Ooh. Now that makes sense, doesn't it not?
No,
it doesn't make sense.
Okay, you tell me what it means.
Well, it means that if you're going to do it, then what you should do is work it.
And that's almost like dancing. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You work it.
Yeah. See? Make it work.
And then when you're singing, same thing. Work it.
Oh,
sing it.
Well, okay, now. And you know I really understood what it meant. I just wanted to hear your take on it.
See, you didn't think that I knew what it meant, did you? Did you not think that I meant?
I knew you knew what it meant.
Let's do one more here.
Okay.
What's the which was there?
Maverick.
Did you know? Where?
The Maverick?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Where?
Can you write it down and tell me.
We have a Maverick? Did we tell you at the beginning of the show that the new monthly Focus on TV guide is now out? And just to let you know, it is a monthly focus.
Nice.
So all our shows that are on channel 46 and 41.
Look at you, look at over there.
Are in this lovely colored brochure.
It is. Brochure.
So keep it on your coffee table for at least a month until you get a new one.
That's true.
And
they will mail it to your house because
there's
I received
an echo
one.
In here. I just heard that.
You did?
Well. Little and they'll mail it right to your house.
Yeah,
how's
little
that?
Echo. That sounds good.
It does sound good.
It is.
Yes. So any other thoughts of wisdom?
Well, I think that the wisdom and thoughts that we've had today have been fantastic. They have been the kinds of thoughts and wisdom that everyone should pay attention to, and maybe they pay attention to these, and if they do pay attention to these, I want you to know that it'll be like I did before, which was a run-on sentence.
Yes.
Yeah, and that was another run-on sentence. Sentences.
That's true.
I can't have it because I have so much fun here.
Oh, I know. And we always have a good time, do we not, Al?
Sure, we do.
We just love it that everybody supports us here and continue to watch Young at Heart, and we'll bring you all this great entertainment.
That's right.
Sometimes that means that's Al and I.
Right. We will see you the next time we see you, which more than likely will be the next time.
On Young at Heart.
Yay!
Bye.
Bye.
Join Lynn and Al next week for another entertaining and informative hour of Young at Heart. Have a good day.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.